how to hack a Wi-Fi network? Well, one easy way is with a pair of binoculars. Hey, who says all hacking has to be done with a computer? Some people leave their router sitting on a windowsill with that ugly-looking password label facing the outside world. Or you could just brazenly walk up to your neighbour's house and peer through the window. Okay, if no one has left a router on show, then you will have to use something like Kali Linux with Aircrack NG. And in this video, I will show you the theory and steps to take in order to crack a Wi-Fi password. And I will also advise on how best to protect against an attack to your network. Despite advances in Wi-Fi encryption technology, there have been greater advances with decryption technology, specifically utilizing ever more powerful graphics cards. Unfortunately, most Wi-Fi passwords are relatively easy to crack. And the reason they are easy to crack is most people leave router settings as the default, with the ISP or router name broadcast to the outside world. So why is this such an issue? The limitations of a WPA2 are 63 alphanumeric characters, upper or lowercase, and some symbols. So that is approximately 95 to the power of 63, which is equal to 3.9 times 10 to the power of 124 combinations, which will take many thousands of years to crack. But taking a known character set and makeup of an ISP router, for example a BT Home Hub 4, which utilizes lowercase hexadecimal characters, excluding zero and no repeated characters, which gives just under 310 billion combinations. Sounds like a lot? Well, a rig consisting of 8 NVIDIA GTX 1080 graphics cards could have that cracked within 27 hours. The method I am going to demonstrate in this video relies on offline cracking, where we will grab a copy of the victim's hashed password when they authenticate to their network. In terms of equipment required, you will need a Wi-Fi device compatible with Linux and capable of being placed into monitor mode. RA-Link-based devices tend to be easily compatible, and for device manufacturer, I would look at someone like Edimax, who ensure drivers are supplied into the Linux kernel. Now to fire up Kali and open the easy point-and-click Fern Wi-Fi Cracker. It's just a GUI front end for Aircrack NG, and although it is easier to use, it may not be as quick to actually crack a password. First off, select an interface. Hopefully you will see your device here, something like WLAN 0 or WLAN 1. Once chosen, it will automatically place your device into monitor mode, necessary for viewing traffic over networks you are not actually connected to. Then scan for access points. You'll now see a couple of network types available in your vicinity, split into WEP and WPA, and the number of networks Fern has identified. If the number is a bit low, move your antenna around or consider investing in a long-range Wi-Fi antenna, or even make your own using a tin can. A decent antenna could span a distance of a few kilometers, so even if you live in a nice open area away from anyone else, an attack against your network may be feasible. WEP, or Wired Equivalent Privacy, is a very basic, crude form of encryption and extremely easy to crack with enough packets. You can simply sit there and listen to traffic from the network or inject your own. Don't use WEP on your own network, you should be using WPA2. So WPA, or Wired Protected Access, is more complex. Simply listening to midstream traffic from a device on the victim's network to the access point and then attempting to decrypt it is not feasible. What we require is the encrypted hash from the four-way handshake when a device authenticates to the access point. How do we obtain this hash? Well, there are two options. One, wait for your victim to connect and listen out for the four-way handshake. Or two, boot your victim off their network with a de-authentication packet, and then listen out for the impending four-way handshake. Either way, we require the victim to be using their network at the time. Looking at the results of WPA, so we have a long list of networks which could be attacked. As you can see, certain networks have the support WPS highlighted. WPS stands for Wi-Fi Protected Setup. it utilises a 7-digit PIN to connect new devices. A serious flaw was discovered with WPS back in 2011, in that once the 7-digit PIN was brute-forced, the WPA pre-shared key, or password, was easily obtainable. 7 digits is just shy of 10 million combinations, and can be brute-forced in a matter of hours. Lesson to learn for defending your network: turn WPS off. Having identified a target, we're now going to do some research on what the password might be. How can we acquire this information? With Google or your favourite search engine. So just scrolling down the page of results and find a useful result here, hacking the BT Hub 304 or potentially more. Let's have a look a bit further into it. And they state wireless keys are a strict length, 10 and in a hex range, so 0 to 9, A to F, case insensitive. But looking further down, someone provides further information in the comments to state that so the length is 10, uses hex decimal with no zeros, no more than 3 numbers or 3 letters in a row, no digit is repeated, only uses 3 different letters. So they do give a rule on how to create this in Crunch. You can either find a dictionary list off the internet or make your own. There is a tool supplied in Kali to make your own word list. That is called Crunch. The format is minimum word length, maximum word length, a character set, hexadecimal excluding the number 0, so I don't want any duplicate characters next to each other. And since I don't want to sit here all day, I'm going to provide most of the password to it. The at characters are what I'm asking Crunch to fill in using the pattern I supplied earlier. And an output file of words.txt in the home folder. So press enter, maximum short length should be the same as pattern itself. Obviously I cannot count. Okay, I've typed too many characters. That's what I meant. So that's going to be 2,744 combinations. Looking at the file, well, that's the first 10 lines, and that's the last few lines. So we found a client on the network, so we're going to select that from the list. Now to load the dictionary into Fern. Looking at the hexadecimal characters at the beginning, that will tell you what the device actually is. In this instance, it is a device made by HTC. Let's commence the Wi-Fi attack, so probing. Now we'll try and de-authenticate it from the network. And indeed, I can see it go offline. Now I can see my phone automatically re-authenticating. Yes, handshake is captured. I've got it. So that tells us the WPA key, and that corresponds with what I have written down. Yes, I have made that look very easy because I knew what the password was, but while my system could have cracked it, I didn't want this video to take hours or days to make. In conclusion, make sure you're using WPA2 for your router encryption. Rename your router in order to deny any knowledge about possible passwords to a potential hacker. Turn off WPS. The 7-digit passcodes can be cracked within a matter of hours. And choose a complex password. And that is it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all later.